Today's Spotlight is brought to you in part by presenting sponsor, Busey Bank. Busey, your dream, our promise.
Welcome back to Spotlight. I'm your host, Jane Winnett. I'm joined now by Brad Wilson and Andrea Coates of the Naperville Park District. So welcome.
Hello. Thank
you. Good to have you here. We love the Park District. So I'm going to start right out with you, Andrea. Tell us a little bit about some of the more popular programs that you've got going on at the Park District.
Well, this summer we have our Movies in the Park. We have a couple in July and one in August and one in September. They're held at Rotary Hill and down south at 95th Street. So it's great. Movies, big inflatable, so it'll be a great event to attend. We also have our Concerts in Your Park that are held mostly on Sundays in the neighborhood parks. They have interactive, the host, the bands, they get really engaged with the kids in the park, so it's really fun to go to that also. We also have Rock the Hill, which that's an event that's at Rotary Hill, and that's also a band that perform on stage, so it's really great.
Yeah, lots of family-friendly stuff there, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I know I've been to the movies in the park, and we've certainly, NCTV's been at the concerts in the park, and you're right, the bands are very engaging and really get out there and make sure that the kids are having a good time, so that's nice. Now, Brad, we're outside, or we'd like to be outside with the summer, right? And you have a lot of things that you do outside, but particularly some new things right down by the Riverwalk, so give us a little bit more information about that.
Yeah, well, you can certainly find your summer fun at the Riverwalk. A lot of residents and people from outside the community come to the Riverwalk for its beauty and the connection to downtown. But what many people may not realize is all the different activities and experiences that we have available. We have the Millennium Carillon, where you can actually take a tour through the Carillon up to the very upper deck. We have very popular Centennial Beach swim facility. We have our Riverwalk Café, perfect location to be able to actually sit out on the patio overlooking the paddleboat quarry, where you can actually rent a paddleboat or even a kayak or paddleboard.
Oh, okay.
Rotary Hill, great location to be able to have a family picnic or to actually even come and fly a kite. And then we also have new this year, Harmony Park, something that we partnered with Rotary Club on to add some musical instruments to the Riverwalk. So a number of just very unique and great experiences when you come to the Riverwalk.
Yeah, and again, all family friendly. I mean, that's always the nice thing. And are the kids enjoying the Harmony Park? I'm sure they are.
Oh, yes. Kids and adults.
And adults.
You see them both out there. Yeah.
That's great. Kind of move over, kid. We've got to get in there. Now, you talked a little bit about Centennial Beach, which obviously is a marquee venue here in Naperville.
Yes.
But you're doing some other interesting things there. It's not just for the sunbathers and the swimmers. So what else have you got going on?
That's right. It's a great location to bring a group out. We have parties that take place there, and certainly there's the normal swimming that takes place. But we have a number of programs that also use Centennial Beach. We have our swim lessons and our diving lessons to where you can learn both of those different skills. We have fitness classes, aquatics fitness classes. We have paddleboard yoga.
Yeah.
So you can try out staying on top of a paddleboard while you're doing yoga. We also have our annual Mud Rats swim team that competes in the Summer Swim Conference. And new this year, we're excited to introduce a water polo, Mud Rats water polo.
Oh, very nice. Yes, a very active league here in Naperville.
Yes.
So.
Yep.
Yeah.
And then in addition to that, we are also offering this year for the first time a junior lifeguard program. So those ages 10 to 14 interested in possibly becoming a lifeguard at some point in the future can come and learn those basic skills, learn from the best, the lifeguards at Centennial Beach, and actually shadow some of the guards towards the end of the summer.
What a great opportunity. I mean, not only are they learning a skill, but I'm sure even for your guards when they have other people shadow, that's a nice little leadership opportunity for them, opportunity to demonstrate some management skills. So
exactly. We're excited to offer it this year.
Yeah, that's terrific.
Yeah.
Now, Andrea, where should we go this summer? You know, you've got an amazing number of parks, but if you were giving us a few quick recos of where we should find ourselves this summer, what would you tell us?
I think one of the big ones is the Knoch Knolls Nature Center. Inside, you have little interactive activities that you could do. We also have a big, how big is the brand, the big tank,
fish tank? We've got a 900-gallon fish tank.
Wow, that's big.
Local species
local
of fish.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that's really neat. We also just Knoch Knolls the whole park. You have a 18-hole disc golf course there with the discs. Lots of trails. I think there's about 5 miles worth of trails. Mm-hmm. So that's a beautiful park to visit. A big playground there also. We have our golf courses. We have Naperbrook, Springbrook golf courses that we have.
Fort Hill Activity Center.
Yeah.
A lot of times people think Fort Hill and the indoor space during the winter months, but it's also a great place to find relief during summer heat.
Sure, absolutely.
And
open gyms.
Absolutely.
Gym,
well, and you also have Nike Park, which is an amazing complex up there as well.
Yes, Nike Sports Complex, a number of different activities. We just added actually pickleball courts last year. So that's a new sport, a new offering available at that location.
Nice, and you got the beach volleyball too there, right? I've been out there a few times playing tennis, and you got the kids out there playing beach volleyball. That's fun.
Yes.
Yeah. Good to watch. Good to watch. You obviously also offer a wide variety of summer camps. I mean, I know my kids grew up there. We couldn't wait to get the book and kind of thumb through and find out what we were going to do for the summer. So give us a few highlights. What are some of the things that the kids can do, different ages? And you know, we're into getting into July. Can they still sign up?
Sure, definitely. We have a lot of our camps are designed to be 1 week, 2 week camps. So we have a full day camps at both Frontier Park and Seeger Park. We have half day camps. We have any type of sporting camps that you can think of. We also have the computer classes. Hmm. You know, we have some of those types of camps, science and technology. So we have a lot of different variety. We have the little guys all the way from the 3 to 5 year olds, and then we go all the way up into the teen camps.
Yeah, I loved Kitty Camp in Naperville. All my kids went through that. I have wonderful memories of that. Terrific. And are they also offering camps inside? Because you mentioned, Brad, about inside at Fort Hill. So are there camps going on in that facility?
Yes, we have camps that will take place at Fort Hill and even our 95th Street Center in South Naperville. We utilize the school district buildings, have great partnerships with the schools. To be able to offer camps there. So really a very wide variety of camps, from the day camps to the athletics to some of the science and technology types of camps. And those are available throughout the course of the summer. So there's time to register for those even as we get closer towards the end of summer. And if you're looking for something for the kids to do before they go back to school, check out our website.
That's great. Now, what other kinds of events and activities have you got coming in the coming months? Anything new and exciting you want to share with us?
Well, Andrea had mentioned before that our Rock the Hill, our concerts that we have, that was something that was introduced last year at Rotary Hill, and we've actually expanded that. So we have a second performance that will take place early in August.
Okay.
So we're excited to...
Backed by popular demand.
Backed by popular demand and an expansion on our very popular Concerts in the Park series, where we, throughout the course of the summer, go to different parks throughout the community and provide live concerts. And then we're also working on... not necessarily events, but a couple of very exciting projects right now. We have an expansion at the Fort Hill Activity Center, adding some studio space for some additional group exercise classes there. And then two large projects, one right next to the 95th Street Library, building a community plaza at that location, and then our Wolf's Crossing Community Park, over a 30-acre park site that's going to have a number of amenities that will be coming in 2020. Both of those parks will actually have the Park District's first splash pads.
Oh.
So we're excited to introduce those.
Yes, that's wonderful. Well, I as a Naperville resident, I can't thank you enough for all that you offer, because it really is a smorgasbord of stuff, whether you're young or old, and the amenities are terrific. And so we wish you a very dry summer, not too hot, and we'll encourage residents to get out and enjoy all that you have to offer. So
thank you.
If you would like to learn more about the programs and events the Park District is offering this summer, please go and visit their website. We're going to take a quick break, but stay tuned. We're coming right back with more Spotlight.